Hi everyone, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to tell you about a problem that you might be having in Cricut Design Space. So let's say you purchased a file from Etsy. Now a lot of times these files, when you search for an SVG file, you'll get an SVG file when you download, but you also have the option of downloading a DXF file, a PNG, sometimes an EPS. So you have to choose which file to upload. So anyway, you go ahead and you upload one of the files and you might notice you're getting some distortion. So let's take a look at a file that was uploaded from Etsy in Cricut Design Space. Okay, here's the file I was talking about. If we zoom in a little bit, you can see that the text is really muddy, and I'm sure yours doesn't look quite this bad, but I wanted to give you a really extreme example of what can happen when you upload a lower res PNG file. So this doesn't actually mean that there's something wrong with the file, it just might mean that you uploaded the wrong file. If you're using Cricut Design Space, you really want to use the SVG file. So let me go ahead and delete this. I'll go through the process of downloading your files from Etsy and then uploading them into Cricut Design Space with no problems. Okay, so let's go out to Etsy now. After you've purchased a file, you can come up here to You. There might be a picture of you here, or it might just be a default image of a person. So we'll click here and then we'll go to Purchases and Reviews. You'll have all the things that you bought, and then you can come over here to Download Files. Next, scroll down a little bit and you'll be able to see either zip files or SVG, PNG, DXF, and that kind of thing. And you'll want to either choose the zip file and download it or choose the SVG file and download it. So we'll go ahead and download this now. When we do this, it saves somewhere on our computer. And for most people, that's going to be in downloads. So if we go to our Finder and then choose our downloads folder, we'll be able to find it here. If you have a zip file and you're on a Mac, you can just double click it and it'll unzip the file into folders. If you have a PC, you'll want to right click and then choose Extract Files. Now let's go to Cricut Design Space. I'm going to increase the size of my window a little bit. And then we'll come over here to New Project. Next, we'll come down here on the left side to Upload. And I'll upload the image. We'll browse for it. And then I'll find the downloads folder. Now, as you can see, we've got a PNG file and an SVG file, and you'll also have a DXF file, most likely, if you downloaded everything. So we don't want the PNG file, even though we can kind of see how it looks when we click on it, as opposed to the SVG, which if you're on a PC, I don't think you can see how it looks. But you want the one that ends in SVG, so we'll choose that one and open. And then we'll save. Then I'll choose that one and insert images. It might be a little big if there's a lot going on. So now I'm going to increase the size a little bit and we'll zoom in. Because we chose the SVG file, everything is very clean. There's no distortion going on like you saw with the PNG file. So if you're using Cricut Design Space, SVG will give you the clean lines that you're looking for. If you're working from a PNG, Design Space is going to try to guess where the edges are. But if you're using SVG, those are already created and it doesn't have to do any guesswork. All right, I hope this video helped you. If you want to check out our Facebook group where we help Cricut and Cameo crafters or anybody who's using a cutting machine, check us out on Facebook. I'll leave a link in the description below. Thank you.